is always the hardest. The first day of school, the hallways, the darkness like a gauntlet. The voice is haunted, walking in with the thin skin, lower chin. He knew the names that they were taunting with: faggot, sissy, punk, queen, queer. Although he never had sex in his 15 years. And when they harassed him, it was for a reason. And when they provoked him, it became open season. For the fox and the hunter, the sparks and the thunder to push the boy under, then pillage and plunder. Kinda makes you wonder how one can hurt another. Well, dehumanizing the victim makes things simpler. It's like breathing with a respirator. It eases the conscience of even the most conscious and calculating violator. Words can reduce a person to an object, something more easy to hate, an inanimate entity. Completely disposable, no problem to obliterate. But death is the silence in its language of violence. And death is the silence. But death is the silence in the cycle of violence. And death is the silence. It sucks to be young and unlawful, to be tougher. When we pick on someone else, it might make us feel rougher. Abused by the fathers, but that was at home. So to prove to each other that they were not homos. The exclamation of the phobic fury. Executioner, judge, and jury. The mob mentality, individuality was nowhere. Dignity forgotten at the bottom of a dumb old dick. And an numb cold stare. On the way, homo was back to name calling. 10 against 1, they had us back up against the wall. They reveled in their laughter as they surrounded him, but it wasn't a game when they up jumped and grounded. And they picked up the bats with a muscle straining. And they decided they were gonna beat this fellow's brain. And with an awful, powerful shout for an hour full of violence, the quickest to brutality and dominance. They didn't hear him screaming, they didn't hear him bleeding. They ran like cowards and left the boy bleeding in a pool of red. To all tears were shed in his eyes while he slid into the back of his head dead. The death is the silence in this language of violence. Death is the silence. But death is the silence in the cycle of violence. Death is the silence. The boy's parents were gone and his grandmother had raised him. She was mad, she had no form of retaliation. The fact didn't have to worry about being on a hit list. But the thing he never thought about was that there was a witness to this senseless crime. Right place, wrong time. Tried as a matter, one of them was gonna do a hard time. Always the hardest, the first day of prison, the hallways, the darkness like a gauntlet. The voice is haunted, faggot, sissy, punk, queen, queer. Words he used before had a new meaning in here. As a group of men in front of him laughing came near. For the first time in his life, a young bully felt fear. He'd never been on this side of the name calling. 5 against 1, they had his back up against the wall. And he had never questioned his own sexuality. But this group of men didn't hesitate their reality with an awful, powerful shout. An hour full of violence, of quickness to this brutality and dominance. They didn't hear him screaming, they didn't hear him pleading. They took what they wanted and then just left them bleeding in the corner. The giant reduced to Jack Horner. Dehumanizing the victim makes things simpler. It's like breathing with a respirator. It eases the conscience of even the most conscious and calculating violator. The power of words, don't take it for granted. When you hear a man ranting, don't just read the lips. Be more sublime than this, put everything in context. Is this a tale of rough justice in a land where there's no justice at all? Who is really the victim? Or are we all the cause, a victim of it all? When death is the silence, in this language of violence, death is the silence. But death is the silence, in the cycle of violence, death is the silence. You won't see the face till the eyelids drop. You won't hear the screaming until it stops. You won't see the face till the eyelids drop. You won't hear the screaming until it stops.